Oh, Boris Martin. Where is my son, madame?
I do not know my father.
He is late. Well, these folk deserve their food. I should like to see them eat. We will not wait for Martha. To table, my friend.
And I said to him, I let him have it straight. And I said, my friend, I wouldn't give you a rotten apple for your son. Like that, I told him, treat a good mare to a bad sire. And what do you get? I said, a foal like a sire. A good mare and a good sire. And you got a good colt. But your stallion, friend.
Right.
I wouldn't give you a rotten apple for him.
Slap, sire. Sway back.
Hello, Songsy. Hello, my fine master. Look, Katarine, how he holds his head. He does well. And you also are late.
You required me, my master, to reckon the harvest for you. And careful reckoning takes time.
Well then, report.
We have a barley from the old field, as many bushels as last year, and 40 over from the new planted field, almost double the sum. We have of wheat 100 bushels and 10, of rye a good round 100, save that of the grain set aside for seed. Two baskets are missing.
And this has made you late.
Even so, my master, I have counted and recounted, but I knew I lost as soon as ever I entered the room.
None but you has held the key for nearly a dozen years.
I remember that, master.
I am waiting.
No one had forced the door, no one disturbed the shutter. Since the last load was brought from the threshing floor, no servant has visited the place. But this morning early, your son requested of me the key, which he again restored to me this noon. I could not think it wrong to give your son the key.
You are trying to say that my son has robbed me.
No, master, perhaps. How do I know? You sent him to fetch it. There is the reckoning. That is all.
The reckoning, indeed. That my son Martel has taken that which was not his to take, or your word against his, that an old servant has lost his honesty.
I have not lied, I have not stolen, master, nor, master, have I accused your son.
You have not lied, then, you have not stolen. But you have accused my son!
He has not lied, my father!
Well, madam...
The grain which is missing from the storehouse is safely stored enough. It is planted in the new field in the spring will be restored to you a hundredfold.
Where is my son? Depends on the succession of an heir. I consider it my duty to forgive him. When he returns and has confessed his crime and has borne his punishment, I shall withdraw my anger. Until that time, rest assured, madam, my anger shall exist. You may return to your place, madam. Where's my children? From pestilence and thunderstroke and sword, protect this house, protect this house. For honest labor, grant us glory, grant us you.
Passes snow
is a good baby, is he not?
None better. When he is grown, he will be a hero, like the great Alexander, for whom he is named.
He is as good a man as his father. I will be content.
Catherine, madame,
why has he not returned?
Perhaps he learned the master's anger was greater than he had dreamed.
The delay increases that anger.
Freedom is sweet, madame. I should myself like to see the Garonne, the Rhone, the plain of Provence. I who have never been but to Lichon, madame, he will return in the spring.
The spring is far away. Freedom is sweet.
Not maybe.
riding along. He's dead. The master is dead.
No, he cannot be dead. Lay him here gently. He cannot be dead.
He fell from his horse and hit his head. That he is dead.
Rub his temples with vinegar. Chafe his hands. His hands are cold.
He was riding in the cold of a winter evening. He fell from his horse. I cannot think why. He sat always so firm in the saddle.
Frightened. The wolves have been close to the farm.
Peace to this house. Why do you trouble him? He is beyond your help.
To its servants,
like a shepherd.
rest, I said. It will take a little time for the news to find him. If he has gone to the north where the fighting is, it will take some time for him to journey home. But he did not come. Catherine! Why does he not come?
Into
thoughts I'm likelier to meet him.
He has been 7 years away. It is a great grief to his wife.
There always comes a day, lady, when any man in his right mind would rather come home than fight. And in the meantime, some of us travel far. I had best be on my way before the darkness grows too deep. The paths are dangerous for those who do not know them. Thanks for the food, lady.
Wherever you go, I beseech you, look for a Bergsma named Guerre.
I'll bear it in mind, lady.
Thank you. Praise God, Martin, that you are safely home.
I do praise God and ask you.
your jet. Prune the trees as I showed you.
Yes, master.
The grey mare, master, she is near to Foley.
I come.
You are not Martha Guerre. It is not possible you should be Martha Guerre.
With child,
good days came back when he came back.
The coldest winter and the biggest hunt.
And a brother for Soxy.
Not yet,
swineherd, not yet. Save the rejoicing. But almost a brother for Soxy.
The priest is with them, and Katharine, it will not be long.
The priest has great love for the master.
So have we all.
Amen.
Will you chatter forever? With the fire gone out and the infant cold? You or would?
But he's lost hungry.
God be praised, a healthy girl.
A girl.
They happen, my friend, they happen.
Thank you.
child!
I have believed this man who returned to me, father of my youngest child, is not my husband whom I married. Believe in this, still I live with him.
Why do you suspect him? Grief and madness.
the devil's subtlety.
I am sorry, madame. There are others beside yourself to be considered. School yourself, madame, to the inevitable.
This world of men and pitch mortal below the knee, like a bird.
attention, Petrone!
Thank you. this man at your request. In the cause of justice, we call upon you to identify him.
Will you, madame? He's an imposter and not my husband.
Madame, is it you?
Testimony only.
Oh my God.
prisoner.
Oh, from the cradle, my lord.
His name?
Dictil, my lord. Arno Dictil.
Have you more to say?
He told me not a month ago that he was playing the part of Martin Guerre, that he had met this Guerre in the wars, that this Guerre had sold him for a little money, the right to impersonate him and to pick up what gold he could.
It is a lie, it's a lie!
Well said,
identity is not proved, although his resemblance to Martin Guerre is great. And whereas the wife of Guerre has testified against him, we declare that he is in fact Dutil, and we condemn him to do penance before the Church of Artigues, and to be hanged by the neck before the house of Martin Guerre.
Not death, not death! I did not ask his death!
Has been granted to Martin Guerre, so called, for the verdict against him. Therefore, he shall again be tried. All those who will testify should come to the court of Toulouse this day 3 weeks, and they shall there be heard.
My God! you do?
Reverend Father, could I not be right? Have you never thought that could be right?
All things are possible with God, but Martin is no rogue. He is just, generous, and kind. All here have known his kindness.
I would have you still.
You insult me. My 50 years of honest life mean nothing here. You so much as say I want to murder my own brother's son. Contrary to reason, contrary to justice, you disregard and you deny the most honest testimony offered at this trial.
My lord, we have with us now Jean de Thiel, brother of Arnaud.
Is this man your brother?
I am, my lord.
Is this man your brother?
My lord, I ask to be excused from testifying.
Is this man your brother?
My lord, I ask to be excused from testifying.
You are excused. Beyond doubt, a man, Detil, who greatly resembles Martin Guerre in body, feature, action, and scars. This has been proved, but such great resemblance, so great a knowledge of the affairs of Guerre, is this possible in another man? There is a child from this marriage since the man's return. The future of this child must also be considered. It is the judgment of this court that the prisoner is truly Martin Guerre. To conclude otherwise would wrong the innocent. It is the verdict of this court that the case be returned to the court in Rio with the instruction that the verdict of that court
stand aside.
Holy God, it is the master!
Silence!
madame. They cannot and should not move my pity. The example of my uncle and my sisters can be no excuse for you, madame, who knew me better than any living soul. The error into which you plunged could only have been willful blindness. You and you alone, madame, are responsible for the dishonor which has befallen me.
Thank you.